Abby, welcome to the show. I'm taking on a new leaf, and it is called Check Yourself Before You Wreck Yourself. It consists of doing the 12 steps in 12 days. Now, most of my videos, I have been hiding behind gym equipment or songs because I couldn't figure out where the fuck I fit. I'm definitely not a personal trainer, and that's why I don't ever explain what I'm doing, because I'm not even sure I'm doing it right half the time. As far as dancing goes, music moves me. And a lot of singers seem to find the words that I just can't seem to find. And I highly recommend finding your power song. Somebody recently said that term to me, power song, and I have to totally agree. We all have our king and queen moments. There's a lot of resources available out there to utilize to get through struggles in life. One of my biggest struggles to get through was alcohol. The resources that I used were, one, AA. I went to meetings every day. I joined a support group and I found a sponsor. I also did a 12-step group where they run you through the 12 steps in about 3 days. You do 4 steps a time. And you keep running these steps because you can't. The first step is admitting that you're powerless and your life has become unmanageable. Well, what are you powerless over? For me, it was alcohol. So I had to admit that I, Ashley, had a problem with alcohol. But I didn't think I did. Everybody else was doing exactly what I was doing. Everybody else was skipping work because they were too hungover. Everyone else was sleeping in because they were too hungover. Everyone else was showing up to parties with a bottle in their hand. Every single social event I ever attended, people were drinking. Since the day I was born, booze has been in my life. So I had to find different resources. I needed to find different outlets. Like I said, going to AA was the first step I took. The first time that I did go to AA, I did look at the end result of no longer drinking. I didn't ever look at the work that it took to get there. I just thought, hey, I'll go to AA. They'll solve all my problems. I'll wake up without a bottle in my hand. Well, that didn't work. And I basically lied my way through all those meetings at the beginning saying, you know, whatever, didn't drink, blah, blah, blah. But I go home and drink. So my life continued to spiral out of control and become even more unmanageable. So at round two, I decided I had enough. I was fucking done with believing I could not live my life without a bottle in my hand. So I started going to the gym. I started journaling. I started meditating. I went to yoga, support groups, and I looked for inspiration in other people who overcame struggles themselves. What I'm going to do is run the 12 steps, one step a day, for 12 days. On the 13th day, we're going to interview some pretty amazing humans. So I'm going to run the 12 steps, 12 days. On the 13th day, we're going to interview someone. Run the 12 steps again. On the 13th day, interview someone else. Run the 12 steps again. Interview someone else. I got 5 interviews set up already for you guys to hear from some amazing people who have made some incredible changes in their lives. So what the 12 steps are, is there a spiritual foundation for personal recovery from the effects of alcoholism? The 12 steps is also used in recovery programs for addictions other than alcohol. Members of 12-step recovery programs have found that these steps were not merely a way to overcome addiction, but they became a guide toward a new way of life. If you are interested in a new way of life, hit subscribe and follow along and see what we can do for you. How the 12 steps work. So it's explained in the big book in chapter 5. The 12 steps provide a suggested program of recovery that worked for the early members of AA and continue to work through the years for many others, regardless of the substance they used. They are the directions meant to provide members with a path to lasting sobriety and a substance-free lifestyle. So if you're looking for that lifestyle, hit subscribe and see what we got coming for you. The meetings of AA is considered mutual support groups where people come together and share their experiences. That's what my interviews are about. People sharing their experiences with overcoming struggles, overcoming personal identifications, you know, already built-in identities, changing their identities. How do you do that? We're going to find out. And our idea is to change the focus of what we're doing. You know, right, for me, I was focusing on alcohol. I was focusing on getting through the day, and I was focusing on Friday coming. I was focusing on who I was going to drink next. So I needed to change my focus. I needed to get a new environment that didn't constantly give me triggers to self-sabotage. Follow Naked and Loud. Hit subscribe. We're going to let you know some new environments that you can get yourself into so you stop self-sabotaging. There was a certain decision that I made that I'm going after this vision no matter what. And that vision was to stop fucking shit up. I said, I am going to stop fucking drinking. And like I said, the first time I didn't do the work. The second time I did. The work is the 12 steps. That is the fucking work. Do it. It works. When I did round two, instead of looking at the end result, I decided I was going to take this one day at a time. And as fucking cliche as that sounds, it is the absolute truth in anything you do. It's for me right now doing these posts one day at a time, just one day at a time. And that's why we're going to do the steps one day at a time. It doesn't need to be scary. It doesn't need to be overwhelming. It can be extremely easy. And we're going to round it out because you can't deal with five issues at once. You can't deal with 10 issues at once. We need to break it down and identify one main huge issue that you need to deal with. So for me, my issue was saying, hi, my name is Ashley and I'm an alcoholic. That was the issue. Once I started dealing with that issue, I could see clearly the other issues that I was creating. And now, at 3.5 years later, today I am 920 days alcohol free, one day at a time. No matter what I did, I stuck to that vision. Today, I will win. And as I did it, I started to love the process. Things become pretty fucking normal when you become the identity. That is living the lifestyle you want and doing it every day. Hit subscribe. 12 steps, 12 days. One step a day, because helping people is part of my passion. And you have to be consistent with running these 12 steps. So that means the first step is admitting you have a problem. The second step is having faith that there might be a way out of this fucking mess. The third step is surrender. Decide to level the fuck up. Raise the bar. Be a better human. Have a higher level to go for, you know, like level up. Vision yourself where you want to be in life and start becoming that person. And you can modify it as you go. So for instance, in AA, they throw around the word God. It's just in this, the higher power that they speak of. God's not really my thing. I wasn't raised that way, and it was just never really there for me. But I do believe in a higher power. So what I did is I modified the word God and changed it to love. So every time they spoke of God in the book or in a meeting, or when I look to my higher power, I look for love. Step out of the known and try different things. Try some things like the yoga, the dancing, journaling, working out. And, you know, we're going to go through some of that stuff. I'm going to give you some tips on how that can look for you if you're not into any of that. As far as, you know, meditating goes, I want to give a huge shout out to Aaron Doughty. He's somebody I follow on YouTube. He helps people expand their consciousness. He basically articulates spirituality for dummies, so you can really understand and follow along and really get into the vibe of it. He's got a lot of information on, you know, venturing into your higher self, how that looks and how to do it. I really highly recommend checking him out. When I was growing up, I felt a certain level of emotional and physical abandonment. And then going through life, there was a certain level of shame I had. I'm not worth it was a daily minute to minute, second by second feeling. There was a people pleaser mentality born that I had to shed. I was changing myself to make other people happy. I wasn't being authentic because if I could get them to love me, then everything would be okay. And then you're doing things you really wish you weren't. In order to influence a new way, I had to recognize that truth. In order to recognize that truth, I had to put down the fucking bottle in my hand because it was fogging the shit out of my vision. And your beliefs, they create your reality. And what a belief is a thought you keep thinking consistently. So for instance, you think you'll never go out again because you can't drink. You have no more fun because you can't drink. You can't go out to social events because you can't drink. Well, you know what, guys? I'm 920 days without a bottle in my hand, and I've been to pubs, parties, clubs, concerts. I go to weddings. I wake up every fucking day feeling 95% fantastic. I still got some issues, but nothing like I did before. And I can actually handle them today. And that's what I want you to be able to do. Don't hide behind that fucking bottle anymore. We are going to get you connected to raise your vibration by switching focus to what works for you. So like I said, modify the shit out of whatever you need to do to make it work for you. When I work out, I don't always have like a arm day, leg day, back day, ab day. If my legs are feeling it today, I'm doing legs. If they're feeling it tomorrow, they're getting it again tomorrow. And if they're feeling again the next day, guess what? I'm doing 3 days of legs because they want it and my arms don't. It's called modify and it works for me. And you know what? I'm in great fucking shape because I'm still doing something. I'm not sitting on my ass wishing for something to happen for me. So what are the 12 steps? Now let's look at that because they are exactly what helped me get through what I needed to get through. So we're just going to quickly brief over these, all right? So the first step, we admitted we were powerless over alcohol, that our lives had become unmanageable. What that means to me is admitting I have a fucking problem. That's it. Hi, my name is Ashley, and I'm an alcoholic. Later on, it became, hi, my name is Ashley, and I'm a liar. Hi, my name is Ashley, and I used people. And then once I started realizing what type of person I was actually being, I could start changing how I wanted to be. Step 2, came to believe that a power greater than ourselves could restore us to sanity. The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and over, expecting a different result. Like drinking every fucking day to get rid of your problems or bring you fun. I started to believe that love was greater than me and could restore me to sanity. 3, made a decision to turn our will and our lives over to the care of God as we understood Him. I made a decision to turn my will and my life over to the care of love. I knew that love would have my back. It would bring me the people I needed, the places I needed to be, and the feelings I needed to have. 4, made a searching and fearless moral inventory of ourselves. That is, check yourself. What the fuck are you doing right now? Are you lying to people? Are you hiding shit from people? Are you fucking your boss over by not showing up when you're supposed to? Are you acting like everybody drinks so the life that it's creating for you is okay? It's not okay. No negative shit's okay. Lying's not okay. Cheating's not okay. We gotta get rid of that shit, right? That's where the hate comes from. Negativity, right? Gross. Five, admitted to God, to ourselves, and to another human being the exact nature of our wrongs. Journaling. That's where I journal. I write down all the shit that I need to get out. I mean, when I was going to AA and I had a sponsor, you'll always find somebody there trustworthy enough to open up to. So, I mean, hands down, if alcohol is a real issue in your life, go to a fucking AA meeting. Like, get in there, go. Tell someone you're a newcomer and you're looking for a sponsor, and you will get one. You'll probably get five lined up for you right away. And you can talk to them about everything that's ever happened. Also, at meetings, you get to stand up at the podium and vent to a room full of people who understand you more than anywhere in this fucking world. Six, we're entirely ready to have God remove all of these defects of our character. So I was ready to let love take all that crap away. Just let love in. No more lies, no more drinking, no more hiding, no more bullshit. Just let love in. I even got my little rose quartz crystal here, always making sure that I'm channeling the love chakra. Seven, humbly asked him to remove our shortcomings. It's like meditating, pray, like, please help me out of this. It's just try to stop acting so fucked up, help me find a way out. Help me see. If you ask your higher power to step in and show you, and you actually listen, you will be shown. That's the trick. And if you follow Aaron Dowdy and watch his videos, he can explain to you on how to reach that high vibration, that higher self. Eight, made a list of all persons we had harmed and became willing to make amends to them all. So you make a list of the people that you fucked over. I fucked over my parents, I fucked over my siblings, I fucked over my friends, and I became willing to make amends to them all. That's not make amends to them all. Willing. You're willing. Nine, made direct amends to such people wherever possible, except when to do so would injure them or others. So we're not here to fuck up other people's lives. One of the, biggest things that is going on around the world is affairs. People are cheating like it's a fucking rite of passage. So let's say you get knocked up by a guy who's married to another woman. It is not your job to tell her you're pregnant with his kid. It's your job to tell him, and it is his story to tell her. So that's where we're not gonna go and fuck up other people's lives by being honest about something that happened somewhere else, right? So there's a line. You gotta be careful. You don't wanna go and you don't wanna fuck people up harder. You don't wanna do that, right? So one of the things that I said a lot, to build my courage to be able to apologize for all the humiliating things that I had been a part of, I would say, I'm really sorry for the way that I acted when I was drunk. I'm really sorry for the way I acted when I was drinking. I'm really sorry for the way I acted, when this was going on. When I got more courage and more brave, I could approach people and say, I'm really sorry about the time that I fucked up your house. I'm really sorry about the time that I drove into your car. There's just whatever it is. I'm really sorry about that night we got in the fight at the bar. They're not always going to accept your apology, and that's not what you're going for. You're doing this to recognize that you have fucked up and that that person absolutely deserves an apology from you. 10. Continue to take personal inventory, and when we were wrong, promptly admitted it. So that's continuing to check yourself. You know, if telling your boss, you know, I'm really sorry I didn't show up yesterday. That was really inconsiderate of me, and I know that you really rely on me being here. Be honest about what you should be doing and admit it right then and there. Don't, when you start excusing shit out of your life, you start excusing more shit out of your life. You start excusing yourself. Let's just say you want to start our workout program. So you start today. Well, tomorrow you're too tired. Well, guess what? You just excused yourself from tomorrow. Now you're going to excuse yourself from the next day, probably the next day. And the next thing you know, you're not even on your workout plan anymore. So you have to admit where you're fucking up, and you have to keep checking yourself, right? Am I being honest? Am I being kind? Am I being loving? Am I being respectful? You know, am I being a good fucking human? And hit subscribe, because we're going to hear from some great fucking humans that you need to hear from. Who are they? Stick around and find out. 11. So the purpose of step 11 is to discover the plan your higher power has for your life. Which also means chill the fuck out sometimes. We need to let the universe take the reins. And that's why you need to hit subscribe and see what my interviewers have to say, because that is exactly what they had been able to do. They're running their lives based on how they want to run their lives, not because they're being paid to do it for somebody else. 12. Having had a spiritual awakening as a result of these steps, we try to carry this message to alcoholics and to practice these principles in all our affairs. And that's why we're going to round out these 12 steps over and over and over, because you have too many issues that we cannot put them all into one day. It's just not going to happen. And you also need a support group. And that's what I'm building here for you. Is I know there's a lot of people out there, let's say doctors, wives, lawyers, teachers, that feel too elite to walk into an AA meeting. Well, I want to welcome you to Naked and Loud. And this is called Check Yourself Before You Wreck Yourself. I really hope that you guys find something that works for you. I've shown videos of dancing and working out, and I gotta say, if I had never walked into one of those AA meetings, I don't think I ever would have walked into a dance class. I don't think I would have walked into the gym. So when I sit here and try and share that shit with you, that's not even what got me to this beautiful, beautiful backyard. Look at my fucking view, guys. I mean, come on, man. When I was drinking, I was living in a 900 square foot, two bedroom, one bathroom house, and there was four of us. Because I was putting all my money into the bottle. Now that I stopped drinking, I got $1 million view sitting behind me, and it's pretty fucking sick. I want you guys to have the same view on life, as beautiful as this. Hit subscribe. Stick around. There's so much shit to learn from people, and we're going to hear from them. We're going to hear from so many people. You're not just going to hear from me all the time. How awesome is that? We're going to do a little bit of dancing sometimes, just because I love music. I might throw in like a workout tip here or there, but I might not, probably not, because we're just running the steps and I want to keep it easy fucking peasy. I was really afraid to walk into AA. I was really afraid to stop drinking, actually. I really didn't think my life could handle it. Now my life couldn't handle alcohol at all. I'm clear. I can handle my shit. I can deal with things. I can have conversations. I'm definitely more aware of who I am and what I need and how to get it. And that's what I want you all to be strong enough for, is yourselves. You deserve it. You know, I felt worthless for years, most of my life, you know, and I didn't know how to get over it. You know, one of the things with AA is being honest about the humiliation, right? So you get up at the podium and you say, "Hi, my name is Ashley and I'm an alcoholic. This past week, I didn't show up for work. I lost my job. I don't know how I'm going to pay my rent, and it's because of, alcohol. It's humiliating. I'm a good person. Why am I fucking saying this shit? Why is this my life? Why is this happening to me? And the more you say it, the more and more and more and more humiliated you feel. And then you have no more humiliation left to feel. You're like, well, what am I gonna, I got it, I haven't been drinking, I stopped, I said all the nasty shit that happened. Then you start talking about life without drinking. Well, I just started a new job. I just got my license back. My kids are home. Everything starts changing, and everyone sitting beside you is in the same boat as you. So, what's there to be humiliated about? So, you start growing dignity. Dignity is a state or quality of being worthy of honor or respect. Don't you want that? I know I did. I did not honor or respect myself at all. And I know if you're drinking, chances are you probably aren't either in many aspects of your life. So hit subscribe. Let's get dirty. Let's go out. Check yourself before you wreck yourself. Bye, guys.